Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Supriya here and welcome to my show, The Good Doctor Show. Today's discussion is about when should you be concerned about a mole or about a birthmark. It's a discussion for the day today. I also want to discuss about dandruff. Yesterday I was not keeping well and hence I could not do any of my videos. So people have queries about dandruff as well is what I want to try to solve if you have queries. If not, then we'll just discuss about birthmarks. We'll wait for a few people to join in, of course, before we go ahead. If anybody has any queries, of course, shoot in your queries in the meanwhile. I will start my session in exactly another 3.5 minutes. Another 2.5 minutes, we will start on with the session. We'll just wait. Hi, Vishwajit Kumar. We just wait for another 2 minutes. Okay, 2 minutes, 10 seconds, and we will start the session. Okay, dhanyavad. Okay, another 1.5 minutes because we have to wait for 5 minutes before we start the session. Of course, you all do know that we have other sessions as well. We do a lot more other shows. We have something which is very interesting, which is called as a Play Store. In the Play Store, we have these crazy discounts which keep happening. So you have to stay tuned or you have to mark yourself as accept the notification that comes along. And you get these amazing discounts. So you can use, of course, you need to use Goqii Cash for it. So you need to just take care of that. So you have enough Goqii Cash and you can obviously earn Goqii Cash via your walking, your striding. We are going to have quiz from next week, I think, from the 1st of July, what they're thinking. During that time, we're going to have these quizzes in which you will get a chance to earn points by answering those queries. So along with your walking, we're even trying to make it a point that you all are more active in terms of, understanding the concepts as well. Okay, another 15 seconds and we should be up and doing, starting off with our video. So how have you all been? Thank you, Deepak. Hi, Deepak. Okay, 5 minutes are done and we're going to end the intro. Okay. Hi everyone, I'm Dr. Supriya here, your Goqii doctor, and welcome to my show, The Good Doctor Show. Okay. So today's discussion is about when should you be concerned that your birthmark or any moles of your body are problematic. When is that? Matlab kab tension lena chahiye? In the last 10 minutes, I am going to try to squeeze in dandruff issue as well. I have had a lot of people discussing about dandruff. People who are online and who want to know about dandruff, then I speak about dandruff. And if you all want me to continue only about the birthmark, then I will continue that as well. So you all can let me know that if I should discuss dandruff, yes, no. Even if there are 4 or 5 people who say yes, discuss dandruff, I will discuss it, okay? But I need to know that you'll want to know. Yesterday I was not keeping well, so I really could not come on the camera and talk. So I'm sorry about that. I did miss you all yesterday, but it was a problematic day for me. Okay. So hi, Dharmraj. Hi, Shehbaz Ansari. Hi. Okay. So we all get these birthmarks as when we are born with it. So you would have had birthmarks at any place in your body. Okay. It can be on any part of your skin. Birthmarks are not necessarily only white in color. Birthmark can also be black in color. Birthmark can be also brown in color. They can just be a little darkish tinge in color. So birthmarks are like that. So normally your nevia, that's what the birthmark is, it is not at all a problem. That's what you've been born with. It's just a color discoloration and it is okay. Okay. The other thing what we have is moles. So many of us get moles, which are obviously different colors again. So you have from brown mole to you have brown, you have black, you have red color moles as well. And these moles come all around your body anywhere. Okay. Moles in your life can come anytime in your body. So it's not necessary that it's only to a certain age. It's a birthmark hota hai. Your birthmark will come as you're, you know, being born. And that birthmark can stretch over time, meaning you can have a birthmark, which is say, for example, in a shoulder area, the shoulder area could actually become bigger. Okay. In that terms, it can stretch, but generally that also does not tend to happen. But, and you have your moles. So moles also tend to come anytime in your life, but you can have a mole here. You can then have it 1 year, then which you never had on your forehead, you can have. So that is how moles are. Moles erupt any point of time. Okay. So you have red, you have brown, you have black. You can have a hair coming out of that mole, everything, everything. The time you need to be very concerned about a mole or a birthmark is when it is a non-age related thing, and when I'm going to show you all. I'm just trying to get something online. Okay, so okay, lots of mole was to my grandmother, my father, and me to some reduce in black. Okay, hi Basak, I'm doing well. How are you, Deepak? You have had, like, your grandmother's had a lot of moles. Then your father's got it and you also got some of them, red and black. That's what I'm saying. So moles are always there. So they're defined. Moles are always defined. You will not have a mole which is very ill-defined. Matlab, you can have a borderline of it which is not very good looking, but that line will also be defined. When you don't have that kind of definition, that's when you're supposed to be concerned. So I am going to show you all an image. So when it turns out to be so-called skin cancer or a problem with the mole, this is how it happens. So your normal mole would be something which is very well defined. As I told you, it can be in brown color, it can be in black color, this is a dark red color, this is red in color, okay? So when should you be worried? As I told you, see, this is not very round, but it is defined, okay? On the other hand, this has got delusional, it's got opened up. So what happens is, one thing is the asymmetry. In this case, there would be a good amount of symmetry, okay? So in this case, you can see one will not match the other one at all. Then the border, when the border or the edges of the moles are not smooth. As I told you, this is very well defined. This is not at all defined. Okay, then the color. Okay, generally when you have a mole or a birthmark, not a birthmark, but when you have a mole, okay, the mole will be of one color. Can you see this is just of a single color? I hope you can make it out. But when it comes to this, you can see a distortion. One thing is that it is completely off track, okay? The borders are not smooth. One half is not similar to the other half and the color is completely getting distorted. Then the other thing is that if the diameter of that particular mole, the diameter is from one end to the other end, is larger than a pencil eraser. So it's bigger than probably the back part of the pencil. So that is okay, but you need to obviously speak to a doctor and find out as to is it a problem or no. Indians generally don't tend to have a lot of issues of skin cancer per se. Hi, Mr. Deepak Prajapati. Indian skins, we don't tend to have a problem with all these things. Skin cancer is not very common in Indian skin tones. What is this? We are more common with lung cancer and other cancers which are there. But skin cancer is generally seen a lot in people who are extremely fair. Okay, so you need not start getting worried about it. Of course, your doctor will first see it, ask you your history. Generally, it will be one of your colleague or your friend or your wife or your mother or your father who will tell you that, you know what, this is looking different to me. तो घर का ही वही तो आपको बंदा अचानक से बोलेगा ये तो पहले नहीं था अभी क्यों है ये तो अभी बढ़ रहा है. तो हम लोग जब खुद को देखते हैं एवरी डे तो हम लोगों को रियलाइज नहीं होता है कि ये कुछ तो हो रहा है इसमें. लेकिन योर नियर एंड डियर वंस विल बी द वंस हू हेल्प यू एंड टेल यू दैट देयर हैज बीन अ डिफरेंस. इन सच केसेस स्टार्ट टेकिंग फोटोग्राफिक चेंजेस. अगर आपको हो पाता है तो फोटोग्राफ्स लेते रहो. सो देयर सर्टेन पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी विच हैज अ मोल विच यू फील इज चेंजिंग. Start taking a lot of photographs of it, that okay? So that is one thing you have to do. So this is when you have, when you should be concerned. Of course, your doctor will then ask you to get your treatment done. So they will do a FNAC. That means they will take out a part of that particular, they'll scrape out the corners of it and send it for testing and see if it's actually a cancerous, non-cancerous stuff. Many a times you can get an acne over this. So that can also happen, but that is okay. Like you can have like a hair coming out or something, which is normal. So when a hair comes out of your mole, it is normal. All of that stuff is normal. So that you need not be worried about at all. Okay. All right. Anybody has any queries when it comes to moles or birthmarks? Because the topic isn't too vast. It's a very small topic. Anybody has any queries? I can move on to dandruff if you all want. For people who did not, I was not there yesterday. Will extra skin kind become a mole? What do you mean by extra skin? While skin going? So I think what you are talking about is a wart. A wart is a different thing. A wart is that skin which is growing, right? That is not a mole. That is not a birthmark, of course. So that requires a treatment. And that, yeah, skin tags on face or like that, will it become? No, Jalan, that is not a mole. That is a skin tag. That's altogether an answer. What you're saying? It's got a peduncle and then it's got that wart on it. So these warts will have to be removed. Many times we have something called as HPV virus, because of which we get that moles. They can just easily be taken off. Deepak, I have not understood your question. Why mole form? I have not understood your query. Okay, so can I start with the discussion of dandruff for people who want to know about dandruff? Is that okay with y'all? If you have more queries about the mole, you can ask me queries. Should I start with the dandruff discussion as well? Okay, so I'm not getting any response. Okay, let me just start with dandruff problems. Dandruff is an issue which happens because of something which is yeast infection. Okay, so dandruff issue is basically an oily skin issue, and it's not a dry skin issue. It's an oily skin issue, and dandruff basically happens mainly because of this infection called as fungi infection or yeast infection. So whenever you have dandruff, you basically have a fungal infection. Understand that not everyone is prone to it, and some people are very highly prone to it. Whenever you have dandruff issues, if it's a small mild form, it will go off with normal treatment like putting lemon on your hair, curd on your hair. All of that might help. But when it comes to drastic, unbearable effect of dandruff, that time what it happens is you have to basically go to a doctor and show it to a doctor. Now the normal protocol of an anti-dandruff treatment involves anti-dandruff shampoo. People who tend to use Head and Shoulders or by themselves, when they tend to use on regular basis anti-dandruff shampoos, it's not good for your hair. Okay, so one thing you have to do is when you have a dandruff issue, you have to always pick up a pH balanced shampoo. Pick up a pH balanced shampoo, and that pH balanced shampoo will help you clear off as much as possible your daily dandruff. Along with this, if you have more dandruff, as I told you, you have to undergo a treatment with your doctor. An anti-dandruff treatment can't be used on long-term basis. It has to be used only for like maximum 2 months. The way your doctor would go about is alternate day treatment of dandruff, then twice in a week, then once in a week. So there's an entire protocol by the end of which, when you'll use once a month, you'll only use an anti-dandruff treatment. So don't try to do anti-dandruff treatment by yourself if you have huge amount of anti-dandruff. If you have a lot of dandruff. Oh, can you all hear me? Because I'm not getting any queries. Oh. Oh. Can someone type in a hi, hello to me so that I know that you all are trying to ask queries to me, because a dandruff issue has a lot of queries. Okay, whenever it comes to a dandruff issue, you need to, first thing is understand that your scalp is producing this, the scalp has, it's more on the side where it is an oily skin. People think it's a dry skin issue and their dry skin is flaking off. That's not the case. It's a proper yeast infection, and that yeast infection is growing. Do not attempt to, like I know of a lot of people who use a lot of Head and Shoulders for the dandruff issue, and the day you stop using your Head and Shoulder, no Deepak, you should not be using Head and Shoulder shampoo at all, and you don't even have a dandruff issue. So do not tend to use that. Every day if you're using a shampoo, please use something like a Sebamed shampoo, which is a pH balanced shampoo. All these Head and Shoulder shampoos and all, you're not getting it because you're regularly using it every day. That is not good for your hair at all. You are really spoiling the pH of your hair, and your body is now getting used to an anti-dandruff treatment on daily basis, which it does should not be happening every day. So whatever anti-Head and Shoulder shampoo you have, I would say use it to wash your clothes off or something of that kind, because it is not good to use it for your hair every day. Okay, so yeah. Then other things about your dandruff. If you'll have queries, I can answer them for you all. Even if somebody has mold related queries, please shoot that in. I can answer that as well. I'm just taking up dandruff because this topic is rather small and I missed my day yesterday to explain that to you all. Once in a blue moon, you can use an anti-dandruff shampoo, like say once a month or something, just to clear off the head if there is any kind of fungal infection, especially in this climate. That is good, but otherwise I don't recommend it at all. Oh God, ask me queries. It gets very boring to talk if there's no queries. Come on, ask some questions. So yeah, your hair needs to be cleared. The pH balance is important. Dandruff issues are graded from 1 to 3. It is much easier for me to speak when you're asking me questions. Okay, so that's nice. Deepak is asking me queries. Some of the nice pH balance shampoos are Sebamed. Sebamed comes up with very good pH balance shampoos. You do have a good pH balance shampoos even by, I think Cipla also has it. They do have very good ones. And if not, you can always go to your chemist and ask them for a pH balanced shampoo. The other thing one must understand is whenever you're shampooing your hair, it's only your scalp. Avoid oiling your hair if you know you have dandruff issue. Many a times people who have dandruff issues will have dandruff issues over here. They'll get acne all the way here. They'll get it on their back and here as well. Okay. Do not tend to oil your hair if you have dandruff issue. First cure off the dandruff issue and then oil your hair. You are helping the fungi grow much better in case you oil your hair. So don't oil your hair, at least especially till the fungal infection completely goes off. The antifungal treatments will be given to you by a doctor very well. The doctor will help you out with what has to be done, what not has to be done. Of course, the towel that you're using, you can't rub your hair. You have to just try to dab your hair and finish it off with that. Do not tend to rub your hair. That's not good for you at all. Okay, so I'm going to take your leave then. No one's asking me any queries. Nobody has any queries regarding to any of the topics. So yes, you should be concerned about your mole or your birthmark if it's changing in shape, in terms of growing too much, too fast, becoming reddish. If you can see a temperature change, if you can see that the color has been changing over a due course of time, the size is becoming bigger, yes, you should be concerned. Keep photographic evidence all the time ready in case, because many a time with the mole, we tend to forget how it used to look. And that is very important. Or even to explain to your doctor that, oh, you know, my mole used to look like this, it becomes difficult. It's always good to, like, the moment you start seeing some changes, start taking a photograph and then compare it every, like, say, every 3 days or something so that even you, even the doctor, when you show it to them, they can actually appreciate what changes are there. Generally, a scrap of a particular area, or they take a punch needle biopsy, and that punch needle biopsy, they will go and give it for examination and then check if there's a problem with anything with dealing with cancer or any of these other things. Of course, you have infections like psoriasis, you'll have lichen planus. So you have a lot of fungal infection also, which mimics change of a mole if it's happening around the mole area. So yes, you have to show it to the doctor. The doctor is going to help you a lot with it. Okay. Hi, Mr. Sajad Basir. Okay. So for my evening topic is how to get flawless skin naturally. It's a discussion for the evening. So I hope most of you are there today in the evening, and I will see most of you all coming. Anybody has any other queries? As for the dandruff, do not oil your hair, comb your hair a lot, wash your comb, all of that is very important, all right? Okay, so I'm gonna take your leave, so take care of yourselves, and I will see you all in the evening. Bye.